I don't know if you've heard, but Sandfest is underway over in Port Aransas, and it's actually one of the largest master sand sculpting competitions in the whole entire world. Each year, more than 50,000 people flock to the Coastal Bend to check out these very impressive sand creations.
Texas Sandfest has been here a very long time, and we're very happy to be back. We are actually come back year after year.
And we are happy to have you, where sculptors say that sand there in Port A is great for their art. Last year, Sandfest was able to give over $200,000 to charitable organizations and scholarship funds.
And that was Tessa you saw there. It's certainly a busy Friday night in the Coastal Bend. In addition to Sandfest, where we sent Tessa, we also went to the rodeo, baseball, and softball. She is everywhere, but she's back in the studio tonight, right?
I did, and I drove the speed limit, and that's what's important. Let's start off with the rodeo, because it's a pretty special night, you know, day two, and it's military night.
We know how much our men and women in the military sacrifice their time, their efforts, even their lives. So it's a great opportunity for us to give back to the community and just honor them in any way we can.
Well, look at that packed house over at the American Bank Center. Estimated over 4,000 in attendance tonight. And why the heck wouldn't they be? You got barrel racing with the best of the best there. You got to love those customized Whataburger barrels. Also, you had the bareback bronco riding event and the event that never disappoints, known as bull riding. Also, crazy athletes just being tossed around like a rag doll there. Watch that. Yeah. And mutton busting. That's always going to be my favorite. It's actually the only event I would try myself, folks. Get in your boots and go down there. Have a good time, because that thing lasts all weekend. And over in Cal Allen, the Wildcats gunning for a 35A district championship win over King. Could they close the deal tonight? Well, there you go. King loaded the bases in the top of the first, one out. The Wildcats cannot pull off the double play, so that does allow a Mustang score in the first run of the game. Bottom of the first, though, Colton Duff at the plate for the Cats, and he just rips that shot down the left field line all the way to the wall. It goes. Duff is off to the races. It's a two-bagger, and Duff all fired up. Check him out. Would eventually get to third, and Bryce Balusek is then going to beat this throw. Watch him just turn on the jets here. He actually beats that throw to first. Duff scores. That ties the game at one, but Cal Allen looking like they're going to sneak away with this one. 6-2, rather. And it's still in the seventh, so it's not quite over, but Cal Allen looking really good. Whataburger Field also very busy. There you can see Sammy the Seagull keeping his t-shirt launcher locked and loaded. Everyone loves a free t-shirt, right? Frisco in town, and the Rough Rider Bats, unfortunately, also locked and loaded. First inning action, runners on the corners, and Michael O'Neill swings away. Runners out at second, but they're safe at home and first, so riders immediately go up one zip. But the Hooks do get this out back here. Pitcher Akeem Bostic, yeah, says nope.com. I don't know if he actually said that, but he got the out. And the Hooks then will get an opportunity to score in the second. Lorenzo Quintana at the plate with a runner on. This is a pop-up fly, and it is caught. But you know what? This one went into extra innings, and the Hooks actually did win it 4-2-3. I love it when we win. Winning's fun.